Today, we continue our series on Unity Dots and get into more details of the entity component system. We'll make our first entities, see how to inspect their data and to what systems they relate to, and we'll create our first system to move our entities. Like last time, chapters and subtitles are available for your convenience. Let's dive into it. If you followed my previous video, first, thank you. Hopefully you liked it enough to come back for more, and I appreciate it. Second, you should already have the project and workspace layout set up. If not, go check out the previous video or download the project from our GitHub repository. Link in the description below. At the time of recording, the current entity's version is 0.51. If you look at this video by the time 1.0 is released, some things may have changed. If that's the case, I'll add details about the changes relevant to this video in the description. With that out of the way, let's make sure your project has no error and enters play mode correctly. While in play mode, you can check the dots hierarchy and systems window. Even though we didn't make any entities yet, you will notice we already have two in the hierarchy window. One corresponds to the scene informations, and the other to the world time. We can see in the inspector the time being updated. The inspector also shows you the relationships to that entity. You can see the relationship with the systems and expand the foldout to look at the entity query the systems operates on. It also has a shortcut to the systems window. In the systems window, you will see the default game loop. The systems can be organized in groups, and we can define the order of both groups and systems within a group to control the execution flow of our game loop. If you click on a system, you will also see in the inspector for that system the entity queries on which it runs. The systems window also shows you how many entities are processed by that system and how much time it takes on the main thread. Cool, now let's make our first entities using the conversion workflow. Exit play mode and go back to the game object hierarchy window and make an empty game object and a cube. In their inspector, enable the convert to entity checkbox at the top. This will tell the conversion workflow that this game object should be converted to entities. We will see how to control that conversion workflow in the next video. Now enter play mode again and look at the dots hierarchy. We can see in addition to the two previous entities, our two new entities. And as you can see in the inspector, just an empty game object already has some components to store its position in the scene. And the cube has even more components to store the rendering data. Let's add a system to move the cube. In your project, create a folder called Scripts and a subfolder called Systems. In that Systems folder, right-click to open the contextual menu and go to Create ECS System. Name the file and open your code editor. Systems have five mainly self-explanatory methods. OnCreate that runs once on creation. OnDestroy, which runs on destruction of the system, OnStartRunning and OnStopRunning, that respectively run every time the system will start or stop, and finally, OnUpdate, that runs every frame. ECS has a fluent syntax to select what data needs to be transformed through the use of lambda expression. A lambda expression is a method definition without a name. We just provide the method parameters and the execution code. In the onUpdate method, you can see we already have such an expression. Here, entities tells us that we will operate on all entities. The forEach tells us that the code will run for each individual entities. And finally, the lambda parameters filters on the entities that have a translation and rotation component. The ref modifier on the translation component lets the system know that it will need to both read from and write to that component. And the in modifier indicates that it will only read from the rotation component. Last element of the fluent syntax, we have the execution mode. By default, the execution mode is Schedule, which tells the system to run on a single thread, but not on the main thread. We also have the Schedule Parallel mode to execute the code on multiple threads, but not on the main thread. And lastly, the Run method that will execute the code single-threaded on the main thread. We will leave the default mode for now and explore the other modes in future videos. To make our cube move forward, we just have to uncomment the existing sections. This system will now move forward all entities that have a translation and rotation component. Save the file and go back to the Unity editor. When you enter play mode, you will see your cube starts moving forward. If we look at its components in the inspector, you will see that the translation component is incrementing along the Z-axis. Looking at the relationship tab, we also see our new system, move, and by expanding the move system, we can see on which entity query it runs. As we define in the lambda expression, the system requires the translation component as read-write and rotation component as read-only. If we look at which entity matches those criteria, we can see that we have two matching entities, the cube and the empty. Looking at the empty's inspector, we notice that its translation is also incremented on the Z-axis. That's because we told the system to operate on all entities that have the translation and rotation components. We did not specify any other criteria, so all entities that have those components will move. And as we can see in the systems window, we do see that the move system operates on two entities. If we want to only make the cube move, we can require the system to only run on rendered entities. For the cube to be rendered, we saw that it stores the mesh data in a render mesh component. So let's go back to the system code to add that restriction. First, we'll need to add the Unity rendering namespace to our file to get access to the component. Now, we could just add the render mesh component into the lambda parameters like so. But since we don't do anything with the mesh data, it's not a good idea to include it there. Adding more parameters to the lambda expression will have consequences on the performance. But that's for yet another video. Told you there is a lot to cover. So, to add a restriction on a component that we don't need to read from or write to, we can instead use one of the three following fluent descriptions. With all, that will require the entity to have all the specified components. With any, that requires the entity to have at least one of the specified components. And finally, with none, that exclude entities that have the specified component. Which one do you think we'll use? We want the entity to be rendered, so it must have the render mesh component. So we will add with all render mesh. Save your file and go back to the editor. When you enter play mode, your cube should still move forward. And if you look at the empty's entity component, you should notice that the translation is no longer updated. Same thing for the systems window, where the move system display it only runs on one entity. To make sure our system still works on all wanted entities, we can exit play mode and duplicate our cube. Offset it a bit to separate it from the original cube, and enter play mode again. Both cubes should move forward, and the system window will show it now operates on two entities. And those two entities are our cubes. One last thing about the systems window. If you click on the left of the system, you will disable the system. So the cube no longer moves forward. It will also run the onStopRunning method of the system. And if you click again, it will run the onStartRunning of the system and your cube will start moving forward again. Great, if you followed me until now, you are already making good progress, but we are not done yet. Our cubes move, but we don't have a lot of control over how they move. So next time, we will see how to add more control over their movement. That's it for today, thank you for watching, like, comment, share and subscribe to get notified of the next videos. You can also check out our other content and socials. See you next time!